Hi, my name is Will Caldwell. I'm the CEO at Dizzle, and I'm sitting down with real estate coach Brian Eisenhower out of Kansas City. And we're here today to tell you more about how to build referral networks to generate more business. And I'm going to introduce Brian Eisenhower. He's here, and have him tell you a little bit about himself. Brian.
Hi, Will. I'm a real estate trainer and coach. I also run a large real estate company in the Kansas City area as well. I've been in real estate for about 25 years now, and really focus the majority of my time on helping agents learn different ways to grow their business, enhance their careers, and try to succeed in the real estate industry.
Awesome. Well, I want to sit down with here with Brian and ask him a couple questions that I've drafted up, and you know, get down to the nitty gritty on how to get out there and build your business referral network, you know, to start generating you some more leads. And to get started, I'm going to ask. We'll start here with Brian. So one of the questions I have for you is: so for agents just starting out, what tips do you have for them to get out there and build their initial business networks?
Well, I mean, I think the key, Will, is with any real estate agent, one of the most important things to do is cultivate a group of people you know, and that's probably not news to a lot of people, although very few people do it. The key to success in real estate, sustained success over a long course of time, is to develop a very independent business where you're not dependent on any single source. You'll see a lot of agents get into the industry and become dependent on asset management accounts during the downturn when they're selling foreclosures, or dependent on relocation, or dependent on even their broker to give them business, or be dependent on other agents to feed them leads or businesses. You see new agents getting stuck on floor time forever. And to have a truly independent business, you need to build your own client database. And that's, you won't see many top producing agents that sustain any longevity in real estate getting into dependent situations for too long. They learn they need to build their own business. And the ones that don't kick themselves for staying in the business 5, 10, 20 years without ever establishing a core group of individuals that they can stay in contact with and refer business to back and forth. And those individuals can actually be divvied up in a lot of different people. Most people will call it your COI, your center of influence. Those are people you know, people you've met. Could be friends, could be family, could be acquaintances, and people that know who you are, basically. That's the high threshold of criteria that it takes to get in that group, is people that have met and they'll recognize your name. And you grow that and cultivate it, and you systematically feed it, so you purposely try to grow that over time. And then you also systematically stay in contact with them. And one of the things I think we're going to talk about today is how we do that with different business relationships, how one of those databases, if not a core part of your database, should be business relationships, owners of other businesses, whether it's their own or they're in sales, where you can actually help them and they can help you.